can't.
What?
Thank you.
Let's pray. Dear God, I want to thank you for everything you've done for me, my classmates, and our families. Thank you for all the good times we had. Thank you for all the bad times we've had. God, I ask for your blessing on these people, these graduates, and their friends and families as they go from here tonight. God, thank you for everything you've done for us ever. And I ask that you keep us all safe, keep us in the palm of your hand. In Jesus' name I ask these things. Amen.
Thank you.
first thing I'd like to say is this. If I knew there was going to be this many people here, you'd probably have another speaker. I told Miss Odom that tonight's speech may sound a little bit like Jeff Foxworthy because of my South Georgia accent. So if you hear some words that you're unfamiliar with, just understand we use them in South Georgia. They just haven't made it to Trenton yet. Seriously, class of 1996 is special to me, and I consider it a great honor for me to speak and be a part of this year's service. It's also great to see this many people here support these young people tonight. When I was asked to speak to this year's graduating class, I sat and thought about what I would say to you in the class of 1996. That could take you with you tonight and would help you in the future. The first thing I did was think back in time when I was sitting in your chair about to graduate. I thought about what could be said to me, the cushion of life's hard knocks and bumps. It seems that everybody during that point in my life was telling me to go out and make something of myself, go out and be successful. Thinking about what I would say to you tonight, I took a long look at my life and also the meaning of the word success. I looked up the word success in Webster's Dictionary and found its two definitions. The first one is a degree or measure of succeed. That didn't mean anything to me then or now. The second one, though, hit home. The gaining of wealth or prestige. Here was a meaning which, when I was sitting in your seats, I wanted to hear. Money, wealth, power, fame. These are the words that most people associate with being successful. As a graduating senior, I thought that if I achieved these words, I would be successful also. However, left out of Webster's definition is a word that many times is not associated with the word success, but without which a person can never truly be successful. This word is happiness. I've seen wealthy people who had all the material things that money could buy, but were never happy. I know people who had power, but experienced very little pleasure with this power. You can pick up a newspaper any day and read about famous people which live unhappy, tragic lives. I think without the word happiness, the word success has very little meaning. I look back when I was your age, and everybody suggested roads to success for me to follow, and offered advice on how I should travel these roads. My parents wanted one road, my friends wanted one road, my teachers another. But I chose the road which I thought would bring me happiness as well as success. I'm not very wealthy, but I receive plenty of rewards every day that has nothing to do with money. I'm not famous or powerful, but I enjoy what I'm doing. I look back at the road to success that I've been on, and can honestly say that every day I wake up happy with my life and what I'm doing with it. This enables me to say that I think I'm successful, but more importantly, I'm happy. I've also learned that the road to success is always under construction. You too must accept that no matter what you do or which road you follow on your successful journey, it is always in need of construction. You must work to be the best son, daughter, husband, wife, teacher, student, employee, or employer. Whatever roles you play on your road, you should work to make these roles better. I've always found that the harder I work to get better, the more I receive in return. Just as no one could have told me when I was graduating, and little did I know then about all the bumps, detours, and stop signs which will be on these roads. You need to understand that your road will be fulfilled with bumps and potholes that can knock you off course. But you must strive to work harder and keep on going. Let me give you an example of a bumpy road to success. This person followed his road in spite of a very difficult childhood, having less than 1 year of formal schooling, having failed in business, being defeated for legislature, again failing in business, being elected to legislature, the death of his fiancée, being defeated for speaker, being defeated or elected, and only having one of his four sons live past the age of 18. Being defeated for Congress, being elected to Congress, being
played in the band, passing a missile man's English test. Giving everything you have at school practice. Finishing a construction project for Coach Miller. Being a friend to a classmate who needed me. Finishing a drafting project for Mr. Phillips' class. And one of the biggest parts of all, getting to tonight's graduation service. Tonight is a big step on your road to success. You're graduating from Dade County High School. Every one of you has a reason to feel successful tonight. And by the look on your face, I can see that you're experiencing the other word which goes along with success, happiness. My closing words to you are to make sure you follow your own road to success while listening to a very important guide, your heart. Your heart will lead you to happiness. Remember, success without happiness is not the success that will last very long on this long and winding road of life. Finally, I would like to give you another definition of success by a famous coach and teacher, Mr. John Wooden. His definition of success is different from that of Webster's. His definition reads, success is peace of mind, which is a direct result of self-satisfaction in knowing you did your best to become your best. Good luck graduating class of 1996, and remember, the road to success is always under construction. So put on your hard hats or your hard heads, put on your work gloves, your work boots, and get busy.
would like to say that I'm proud to be a member of the second graduating class of the new Dade County High School and stand here as class representative. I believe that this group of young adults will always be remembered because we are overall a very good group of young people. I believe that we have been a big influence on this school and community. I just want to encourage you, my classmates, to put the Lord Jesus Christ as the number one priority in your lives. There's many roads in which you can choose in your life, but the way He has for you is one that's always the best road. If you choose that road, your life will be happy and filled with contentment. Now it's time for us to move on. Our class for the future began the first day when we entered high school. As freshmen, we saw school as it's going to be the longest 4 years of our lives. We couldn't wait to get out. But as seniors, we think somewhat differently. We look back and think about how we could have done things differently. We could have studied more, taken fewer naps in class, listened a little more carefully, or had better excuses for why we were late in class. Seriously, we should have thought about what we wanted to be as seniors when we were freshmen. Now, we can't change the past, we can only look toward the future, making the best of what we've become. The best way to predict the future is to create. The way that one creates the future is to prepare for it. Preparation is training and emotionally equipping oneself for the task at hand. The great athletes rally before well-known games without putting in the practice time on the putting green. A concert pianist who doesn't practice countless hours never reaches Carnegie Hall unless he buys a ticket. If we prepare ourselves for the future and work hard towards a goal, then success is just around the corner. It's up to us. I want to conclude with a little bit of history, but I won't go back too far. Chad Foster, who graduated 2 years ago, always said that a person can be whatever he or she wants to be. One just has to apply oneself and work hard to achieve one's goals. He did, and now he's enrolled in the United States Military Academy at West Point. I'm not saying that we should listen on him like Chad. I'm just saying that we should be all that we can be.
Best Before us are many roads leading to the rest of our lives. Each of us will take a road that will be different from that of others. For some, the road will be short. But for the majority of us, when we meet at our class reunions, we will still be traveling that long road. Right now, on this road, there are many decisions for us to make concerning what lies ahead. Some of us will settle down and have families right away, and others will pursue careers. We will encounter many obstacles on this path, many of which we cannot control. However, there will be those we can control, based on the decisions and choices we make in our lives. Our parents will no longer make the decisions for us. We will be on our own. Our high school years have been filled with many memories and fun times, but we have many memories yet to make. Through the ups and downs in our lives, we must remain focused on the goals we have set. It is our responsibility to reach these goals and make them a reality. The future is in our hands. Which road will we choose for our future? The decision is ours. Will it be an easy road with no goals or challenges, or will it be a challenging road where we make our dreams come true? Perhaps Robert Frost said it best in the first and last stanzas of his poem, The Road Not Taken. Two roads diverged in yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both, and be one traveler long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. I shall be telling this with a sigh somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in the wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Thank you.
Thank you. Would first row please stand? Jennifer Lynn Christopher. Angel Ray Smith. James Michael Melton. Nathan Andrew Stewart. Mark Anthony Stallings. Amy Amanda Avery. Carlin Dara Ballard. Marisa Donita Black. Amber Danielle Bradford. Jillian Faith Brown. Jeffrey Earl Bryan. Kevin James Carroll. Selena Diane Chambers. Tommy C. Cutshaw. Y'all may be seated. Oh, check. Heather Lee Daniel, sorry. Now, y'all guys can sit down. Second row, please stand. Joshua Martin Daniel. Charles Michael Davis II. Janet Lynn Durrell. Alicia Jane Holcomb. Christina Michelle Husky. Wendy Lynn Johnson. Philip Shane Keel. Serena Nicole Keel. Dusty Michelle McGrath. Nicholas Adam Moses. Rhonda Caroline Newgard. Andrew Wayne Phillips. Dawn Janine Prince. Stephanie Colleen Ripper. Shannon Marie Cheryl. Y'all may be seated. Third row, please stand. Derry Dania Smith. Josie Leanne Smith. Valerie Jessica Smith. Douglas Thomas Steele. Robert Brian Taylor. Faith Melissa Beal. Jesse Nathaniel Weathers. Yeah. Courtney Elaine Wheeler. Charles Allen Abercrombie. Hendrix Lamar Abercrombie Jr. Cable. Benjamin A.O. Castleberry. Y'all may be seated. Next row, please stand. Travis Nathaniel Clark. Thank you. Christina Heather Edmondson. Dustin R. Ellison. Holly Nicole Forrester. Christopher Keith Gamble. Jason Andrew Getty. Y'all may be seated. Next row, please stand. Joseph Anderson Getty. Tracy Williams Goff. Anthony Carl Glenn Goins. Jonathan Edward Green. Teresa Renee Guppy. Christopher Charles Gwynn. William David Hales. Samuel Duan Harris. Philip Perry Hartline. Eddie R. Hurd, Jr. Amber Christine Hill.
Thank you.
Neely. Molly Suzanne Neely. Joshua Allen Newsom. Ryan Keith Owens. Y'all may be seated. Next row, please stand. James Robert Page. Rebecca Lynn Payne. Robin Jean Poe. Cassandra D. Porter. Jessica Mae Powell. Christopher Emmanuel Rees in absentia. Shauna Lynn Riley. Amanda K. Robertson.
Get him, Speedy.
Margaret Denise Russell. Stacy David Sanford. Jonathan Allen Schroeder. Thank you. Gregory Robert Smith Jr. Jody Lynn Smith. Henry W. Spencer. Y'all may be seated. Next row, please stand. Timothy Glenn Stockman. Dewey Lee Strickland. David Gary Thompson. Tabitha Gail Walden. Melinda Jewel Wallace. Jennifer Renee Watkins. Jason Scott Shane West. Robert Lee West in absentia. Misty Dawn Whittington.
What is it with the belts?
The belts?
Yeah, they're taking her belts off and giving them to it.
Samuel Kevin Wilson. Jennifer Renee Wooten. Benjamin Curtis Wright. Last row, y'all may be seated.